Hey friends, welcome to the YouTube channel All About Electronics. So in this video, we will solve some problems based on op-amp. So these are the topics which we have seen so far in this op-amp series. So here we are going to solve some 8 to 9 problems based on these topics. And here I am going to divide this video in a two parts so that the video will not get too long. So here is the first example, and in this example, we have been given this particular circuit. And we have been asked to find the overall output gain of this circuit. So now here the value of R1, R2 and R3 is 1 ohm, while the value of L and C is 1 microhenry and 1 microfaraday respectively. And the input to this circuit is cos of 10 to the power 60. So now if you observe this circuit, it is the combination of non-inverting and the inverting op-amp. So, and we know that for the non-inverting op-amp, the gain can be given by the expression 1 plus Z2 divided by Z1, where Z1 and Z2 can be either resistor, capacitor or inductive reactance. So in this particular case, if you see, for this particular portion, the Z2 is equal to R1 and Z1 is equal to the reactance of this inductor, that is equal to XL. Similarly, for the inverting op-amp configuration, we know that the gain can be given by the expression minus Z2 divided by Z1. So for this particular portion, Z2 is equal to this R3 and Z1 is equal to R2 plus XC, where XC is the reactance of this capacitor. So we can say that the overall gain will be equal to the product of this individual gain. So here we know that the A1 is equal to 1 plus Z2 divided by Z1, or we can write it as a 1 plus R1 divided by XL. Now here we know that R1, R2 and R3 is equal to 1 ohm, while the value of this inductor is 1 microhenry and the operating frequency is equal to 10 to the power 6 radian per second. And here XL will be equal to J into omega L. So if you put the value of this omega and L into this equation, then the value of this XL will come out as J 1 ohm. So if you put these values, then the value of A1 will be equal to 1 plus 1 divided by J, or we can say that A1 is equal to 1 minus J. So in this way, the value of this A1 will be equal to 1 minus J, that is the gain of this non-inverting op-amp. Similarly, for this inverting op-amp, the gain A2 will be equal to minus Z2 divided by Z1, that is equal to minus R3 divided by R2 plus XC. Now here we know that the value of this capacitor is 1 microfarad. So XC can be given by the expression 1 divided by J into omega C. And if you put the value of this omega and C, then the value of XC will come out as 1 divided by J. So let us put all these values in this expression and let us solve this expression. So if you put all these values, then we will get minus 1 divided by 1 plus 1 divided by J, or we can say that is equal to minus 1 divided by 1 minus J. So in this way, the expression for this A2 will be equal to minus 1 divided by 1 minus J. So the overall gain will be the product of A1 and A2, that is equal to 1 minus J multiplied by minus 1 minus J, and that is equal to minus 1. So the overall gain of the circuit will be equal to minus 1. So now let us see our second example. So in this example, we have been asked to find the output voltage in terms of this V1 and V2 voltages. So if you see this circuit, in this circuit, the input is applied at both inverting and the non-inverting terminals. So to find the output voltage, what we will do, we will consider only one voltage source at a time and we will find the output voltage. And later on, we will add the individual responses to get the final output. So now let us consider this voltage source V1 is acting alone and this voltage source V2 is equal to 0. So if you observe the circuit, then the circuit will look like this. That means this node is at a ground potential and this configuration is nothing but inverting op-amp configuration. So let us find out the output voltage Vout for this inverting op-amp configuration. Now here, if you observe, this terminal is at a ground potential. So because of the virtual ground concept, this node will also at a ground potential. Or we can say that the voltage at this node is equal to 0 volt. Similarly, the other end of the 2R resistor is also at a ground potential. So we can say that no current is flowing through this resistor 2R. So this resistor 2R will not play any role in this circuit. So let us say the output voltage for this circuit is VO1. So this output voltage VO1 can be given by the expression minus RF divided by R1 times this voltage Vin. Now here this feedback resistor RF is 3R and this resistor R1 is nothing but this resistor R. So the output voltage VO1 will be equal to minus 3R divided by R multiplied by this input voltage V1. Or we can say that the output voltage VO1 will be equal to minus 3 times this voltage V1. Similarly, let us consider this voltage source V2 is acting alone and this voltage source V1 is equal to 0. So in this case, this voltage source V1 will be at a ground potential. So now if you observe over here, this resistor R and 2R will be in a parallel and this circuit configuration is the non-inverting op-amp configuration. So let us say for this non-inverting op-amp configuration, the output voltage is VO2 and it can be given by the expression 1 plus RF divided by R1 times the input voltage Vin. Now here this feedback resistor RF is 3R and the value of R1 is the parallel resistance between this R and 2R, that is R in parallel with this 2R, which is equal to 2 by 3R. So our output voltage VO2 will be equal to 1 plus 3R divided by 2 by 3R multiplied by the input voltage V2. So the output voltage VO2 will come out as 11 by 2 times this voltage V2. So now let us consider this voltage V1 and V2 acting simultaneously. So in that case, the overall output voltage Vout will be equal to summation of these individual responses. That is equal to minus 3 times V1 plus 11 by 2 times this voltage V2. So that is the expression of the output voltage in terms of this input voltage V1 and V2. Similarly, now let us see the third example. So in this example, we have been asked to find the 3 dB frequency of the circuit. And here assume that the op-amp is an ideal op-amp. So first of all, let us redraw the same circuit. So here, this combination of this resistor R and C will act as a low pass filter. And let us assume that the voltage at this node is equal to V plus. Now at this node also, the voltage will be equal to V plus because here we have been given that this op-amp is an ideal op-amp. So no current is flowing into the terminals of the op-amp. And because of that, there will not be any drop across this 10 kilo ohm resistor. So the voltage at this node will be also equal to V plus. So here this op-amp is configured in a non-inverting op-amp configuration. So the output voltage V out will be equal to 1 plus RF divided by R1 times the voltage that is appearing at this positive terminal, that is equal to V plus. So here the response of this low pass filter will be get amplified by the gain of this non-inverting op-amp. So for this circuit, the 3 dB frequency or the cutoff frequency will be the cutoff frequency of the low pass filter. And we have already seen in the video of low pass filter that the cutoff frequency FC can be given by the expression 1 divided by 2 pi times this resistor R and C. So if you put the value of this R and C, that is equal to 10 kilo ohm and 0.1 microfarad, then this 3 dB frequency or the cutoff frequency will come out as 159.1 hertz. So in this way, the cutoff frequency of the circuit will be equal to 159.1 hertz. So now let us see the fourth example. So in this example, the gain, that is V out by V in, is equal to minus 12 and we have been asked to find the value of this resistor R. So now here, to find this value of R, what we will do, we will apply the KCL at these two particular nodes. So let us say this node as a node A and this node as a node B. So by applying the KCL at these two nodes, we will find the value of this resistor R. So first of all, let us apply the KCL at this particular node A. So let us assume that at this node, the voltage is equal to VA. So applying KCL, we can write VA minus Vin divided by 10 kilo ohm plus VA minus VB divided by 10 kilo ohm, that is equal to 0. So now here, this non-inverting terminal is at a ground potential. So because of the virtual ground, this voltage VA will be also equal to 0. So we can write 0 minus Vin divided by 10 kilo ohm plus 0 minus VB divided by 10 kilo ohm, that is equal to 0. So if we simplify it, then we will get VB that is equal to minus Vin. So that is the first expression. Similarly, now let us apply the KCL at this particular node B. So applying KCL, we can write this VB minus 0 divided by R plus VB minus VA divided by 10 kilo ohm plus VB minus Vout divided by 10 kilo ohm, that is equal to 0. Now this node A is at ground potential, so we can rewrite this expression as VB divided by R plus VB divided by 10 kilo ohm plus VB minus Vout divided by 10 kilo ohm, that is equal to 0. So if we simplify this expression a bit, then we can write VB divided by R plus 2VB divided by 10 kilo ohm, that is equal to Vout divided by 10 kilo ohm. Now we have seen that this value of VB is equal to minus Vin. So let us put this value in this expression. So if we put this value, then we can write minus Vin divided by R minus 2Vin divided by 10 kilo ohm, that is equal to Vout divided by 10 kilo ohm. And if we simplify this expression a bit, then we can write minus Vout divided by Vin, that is equal to 10 kilo ohm divided by R plus 2. Now here we have been already given that the ratio of this Vout by Vin or the gain of this circuit is minus 12. So minus Vout by Vin will be equal to 12. So we can say 12 is equal to 2 plus 10 kilo ohm divided by R, or we can say 10 kilo ohm divided by R, that is equal to 10, and hence the value of R will be equal to 1 kilo ohm. So in this way, for the given circuit, the value of R will be equal to 1 kilo ohm. So in this way, in any op-amp example, if you find that it is not possible to apply the inverting and the non-inverting op-amp equations directly, in that case, you can use these KCL equations, and based on that, you can solve any problem. So now let us see the fifth example. So here we have been asked to find the voltage gain of this op-amp, and here assume that the op-amp is an ideal op-amp. So now here, if you observe, the input is applied at the inverting terminal, but for this circuit, we cannot directly apply the expression of the inverting op-amp gain. So let us see how we can solve this problem. So if you observe over here, this non-inverting terminal is at a ground potential. So because of the virtual ground, we can say that this node is also at a ground potential, or the voltage at this node is equal to 0 volt. Similarly, if you observe the other end of this resistor R3, it is also at a ground potential. So we can say that the other end of this resistor R3 is also connected at this node. So let me just redraw the same circuit so that it will be get clear to you. So if you redraw the circuit, then the circuit will look like this. So here the output is feedback to the input via the parallel combination of this resistor R2 and R3, and let us say this parallel combination is RP. That means RP is equal to R2 in parallel with this resistor R3. And if we again redraw the same circuit, then it will look like this. So here the output voltage is feedback to the input via this parallel combination of R2 and R3. And for this configuration, we know that the gain can be given by the expression minus RF divided by R1. Now here, this feedback resistance is nothing but the parallel combination of this R2 and R3. So we can say that the gain of this circuit is equal to minus R2 parallel R3 divided by this resistance R1. So that's it for this video. In the next part of this video, we will solve some more problems based on the op-amp. So I hope in this video you understood the different problems which we have covered. So if you have any question or suggestion, do let me know in the comment section below. If you like this video, hit the like button and subscribe to the channel for more such videos.